Hello friends on YouTube, welcome to another video. Today we have a beautiful day, at least it's not raining, and I'm out with a scooter. I was testing it the last few days a bit, and I want to give you a bit of an update because there are a few questions and I want to answer them as good as I can. And yeah, let's just talk a bit. And if you didn't watch the preview video, I would recommend you to watch it. This is where you can see how I downgraded this scooter, or unlocked it, let's say. So let's answer a few questions. The first question is, can we update the scooter? And if you connect to the Segway app, in my last video I didn't connect it properly, but I connected now to the Segway app and it's showing the updates, but you cannot update it with the Segway. You can try it, but it will give you an error, and this is normal. But if you want to update it, you can go to the Scooter Hacking Utility, go to Flash, then load from repo and VCU, for example, and select the latest one, the one with the highest number, let's say. On the Max G3 now, it's currently the 1.5.8. And the bot gave me the 1.5.5 compat. And this is the one I have currently. But I flashed also the newer one and tested it with the newer one. And also you can then go to load from repo and then select MCU and select the latest one, the 1.4.12, it's for the G3, and then you have no updates. There will be no updates showing up in the Segway app, and then you can connect it and set everything up at the Segway app. I didn't see any errors or something, so everything worked. And one thing that I read, I missed that, and somebody pointed out that we should first try to flash the VCU and then the MCU. So my friend from eScoot Talks, he has the same scooter, European version, and he had also the latest updates, and he tried to flash it and he made a video. I will put it down in the video description. And the thing was, he flashed first the VCU and afterwards he tried to flash the MCU, the motor controller unit, but it showed him an error. And the thing is that it downgraded the MCU, so it looked like as he was flashing the VCU, it also flashed the MCU. Maybe I'm wrong here, but we checked a firmware and he was like on the same firmware like I was, but he only flashed VCU and didn't have to flash, it looks like, the MCU. So yeah, just to tell you, if you have any errors, maybe you can check after flashing the VCU what firmware it shows you. So you can go to Scoot Hack until the info tab and you will see all the firmware. Yeah, that's something interesting. So it is maybe possible that you only need to flash the VCU on the G3. And on other scooters, I will put the screenshot inside. It's like recommended to flash VCU first and then use the some special version. There is like, if you go load from repo, then select the VCU. And you can see there is like a 1.5.6. For mine, it's like the 100 kilometer per hour version, and I tried it out on the G3, but I didn't achieve 100 kilometers per hour. But it looks like on other models that you should flash this one. So just to let you know, if you have any issues or you can't reach the speed or so, try maybe with this one. And for the firmware now, currently I have the 1.5.5 VCU and the 1.4.8 MCU. It's like the one that the bot suggests you, let's say, or the bot gives you. And I'm running with this firmware. There are a few things that do not work, but it's okay for me. And for example, I have a NAMI scooter and I also like to have the e-brake completely turned off. And then I don't know, I can better control the brakes. Of course, you have to press them in a bit harder, but I'm a large guy, I have enough power. And a lot of people who are racing, they're also deactivating the e-brakes and just braking with the levers, let's say. So some people prefer it without e-brake, some people like the e-brake. So if you want to get rid of the e-brake, let's say currently, you can keep the 1.5.5. And if you want to have the e-brake, you can update to the latest firmware. So just, you know, go to Flash, load from repo and select the latest one, and then you will have e-brake. And then also you can select the acceleration behavior, so it can be like eco mode or standard or max acceleration. And on the one that I'm currently now, it doesn't have this option. And also what I found out, I wanted, for example, if I borrow somebody this scooter to drive, I would like, you know, to be able to activate the KERS, so the kinetic energy restore system, or how it's called. So if you let off of the throttle, it will like brake. Now it's like a single pedal drive on Tesla, for example, or so if you let off, it will brake, and you can adjust how fast it will brake. And normally you can set it up to switch the modes, so like off, brake a bit, or brake a bit harder with this custom button here. But on the current version that I have, it doesn't work. And if you want it to work, you can update to the latest and then it will work. So yeah, you can play around. Now if you have the compact version, there is no flash protection, and it's easy, you know, you can now easily change stuff. And if you want like to go after this update to stock firmware, I assume that it will be possible. So like to go to stock firmware and then just use the Segway app to update, I think it will be possible at some point. But Adidas maybe didn't allow it, I assume. So if, for example, some new BLE update or something comes out, then maybe it will cause some problems with the scooter. So it's better maybe to prevent Segway updates and to verify first that updates are okay, and then just release it with a Segway app, with a Scooter Hacking Utility app, and then you can just flash it from the Scooter Hacking Utility app. And also something that I saw, if you have the latest firmware installed now and you go to the flash tab, to the tools tab, then you can, for example, go to sport max speed and go to max speed to 100 kilometers per hour, but then it will go slower. So you can make sure to do not set it above 45 kilometers per hour. Yeah, that's something interesting also. And one more thing that I found out, but I would have to switch it to flash it again, but you can try out and report, is if you, for example, now use the latest firmware and then you set the acceleration to the max acceleration, then you use the eco mode or the drive mode, then when you accelerate and you reach the max speed that you set, for example, if you set 16 kilometers per hour and 25, then when it reaches the 25, it will like abruptly brake. It's like not very smooth, so you will like, it feels like it's braking, you know, it is like a sudden stop of acceleration. And after on the 1.5.5 and 1.48 that I'm now, it's really smooth. And yeah, you brake, yeah, if you, yeah, you can decide however you like it. Also, if you want to activate the cruise control while you're driving, you have to drive above 6 kilometers, 6 or 7, and then press the mode button and hold it for 1 to 2 seconds, and then it will show up that it's active. And so also cruise control works. That's also cool. If you switch to the US version, that's nice. I would also recommend you, once you change the serial number to the yes version, you can bind it, of course, to the Segway app. And I would return back to the Scooter Hacking Utility and change it back to the original serial number, and then connect the scooter again to the Segway app. So you bound it again, and then in this case nobody else can use your serial number. And it would be not so good if you, for example, revert everything back and then you cannot connect to the serial number that your scooter has, you know. So to prevent this from happening, just bind two scooters, let's say. And it can also happen that you change to the US version and then you cannot connect with the Segway because it is already used. In this case, you can go to custom and change it to a higher number. Like, you know, you can put, for example, the last four digits, put like 99 and then some numbers, and then this is for sure not used normally because Segway will not use 99 at the beginning of the last four digits. And it will not happen that you like block a serial number of somebody who really bought the scooter and wants to connect it. If you have a D or an E, it's like the same scooter, only software, one letter defines how fast they can go. So you can also flash the D version, the German version. And I want to show you something that I've rode with Charles. It's crazy because I had experiences with other softwares. And yeah, they're not that that cool, let's say. And the Charles or the scooter hacking team, I asked him, hey, give me your PayPal, I want to donate something. And I didn't realize that there is a donation page actually. But he wrote like, no, I do not need any money. I'm just doing it to let people, you know, enjoy their scooters. And it is so crazy. It is like, he's a hero, man. Really, I respect that. I really respect that. There are not many people who are like him. Yeah, it's great. He's really a cool guy. And that's the reason why I want to support him, of course. And I donated, although he said I do not have to. But yeah, you know, I have to give something back, let's say. And for all the people, I know there are some people who are saying, yeah, you're making like tutorials and it is dangerous and you're now some kids will maybe die because of you, because you show them how they can speed up their scooters. Everybody has their own responsibility. It doesn't matter. A kid, it has to be maybe 12 or older. So I think that they have a brain and they should know the law. And they should know what is legal, what is illegal, and it is their own decision, and maybe also the decision of their parents to have to overwatch them a bit and make sure what they are doing, and maybe explain them and show them how things work maybe in life, and maybe they need a bit of responsibility. But I do not feel like I'm showing something bad, because I had a few people, for example, and it can happen that this throttle, I don't know, but the older ones on the G3, the G2 maybe, on the G30, after some time, maybe the spring will get worse or some friction can happen here. And then if you let the throttle off, it will like it will not go back all the way, but it is functioning. But it will just stick maybe a half a centimeter or so below, and then when you drive and you let go, then it will not stop accelerating. So this is also dangerous, you know. And somebody can die because of this too. And you would have to replace it, let's say, if you cannot fix it, like, I don't know, lubricating it or so. But with a scooter hacking firmware, you can just adjust the hull sensor settings and just increase the minimum value. And then it will just ignore that it is sticking here. It will work, because then you have... if you release it, this guy, he had to release it and then like push from downwards to stop from accelerating. It's so stupid, because if you let go of the brake, it will still accelerate, because the scooter thinks he's moving, and he always had to like let go and then push upwards. And just by adjusting the hull sensors, I was able to fix it, let's say, and he can keep it, you know. It's not e-waste suddenly, you know. It's great. Also, some people, I had a guy, I made a video, and I asked him if I can upload his story a bit, let's say. And he said, yeah, of course. And it was one of my first videos where I flashed the G30. And yeah, he was challenged, and it was hard for him to push the scooter. You know, he needed the scooter because he can't walk. He can walk, but not that good. And he needed a scooter where he can maybe push to 1 km/h, because it was hard for him to push to 3 km/h. And then I adjusted it to 1 km/h, and he was able to use his scooter and to be mobile, you know. And why do companies, and I don't know, everybody takes us the possibilities away, you know, to adjust stuff. Yeah, this is something I don't like, you know. It's like babysitting adults or people who have a brain and can use their brain and know what they're allowed to and what they're not allowed to. And for me, 100% I would sign it. It's more dangerous when I see teenagers with 14, 15 years who are sitting together on the scooter, like staying, sorry. One is staying here on smaller scooters than this one, without suspension, and they're jumping around, I don't know. And one is staying here and the other one is behind, you know. And if that one is braking, the other one is like hitting him from behind, yeah. But it doesn't matter. The thing is, they're staying in a totally wrong position and driving around without helmets, without anything. And this is more dangerous, you know. And this is why people maybe fall down, some shit happens, and then they're like, oh yeah, the guys who are tuning their scooters a bit, they are the dangerous ones. But I think if in order to tune it, you have to understand the technique, and you have to be maybe a bit, yeah, you have to work on it, you know, to understand everything behind it, and then you're maybe also more responsible and more aware of things. and maybe even a better driver and have less problems, less accidents. And yeah, this is what I want to say. Also, what I saw, I don't know how it's in other countries in Europe, it's in Austria, I can tell. I saw in media, and they're like pushing this agenda that, yeah, scooters are so dangerous and all these drivers who are overtaking, I don't know, police cars, yeah, some stupid guys, of course. And now they're trying, I don't know, to force us to pay. Yeah, now they just want to make money, you know. It's, of course, I saw the last few years, more and more guys are getting scooters, or children, or adults. So the scooter business is rising, you know. So I don't know how many percent more people are now on the roads with scooters. And of course, the more people drive scooters, the more accidents there will be. And now they're like, oh, this year there are much more accidents. It's because the scooters are so tuned. It doesn't have... It's not logical. Of course, there are more accidents when there are more scooters on the road. So you have to compare how many scooters are there and how many of this percentage are accidents. And probably it's getting down even, but they're like scaring people to, yeah, there are so many, we have to do something about it. And then these stupid guys who are not thinking about it, we're like, oh, yeah, yeah, you're right. We have to, I don't know, stop scooter usage. And yeah, if you have any questions, you can, of course, write them down. And I want also to thank all the subscribers, all the channel members, all the guys who are from time to time donating when I can help them somehow. Thank you very much. Thank you also to all the guys. I guess some of you already donated to the scooter hacking team.